Let's talk the Disney PhotoPass service, the Memory Maker, and the Capture Your Moment photo shoots. All three of these things are integrated into each other, and this is what you need to know about your upcoming Walt Disney World Resort trip. I'm Terry with Creating the Magic, and I help you plan your Walt Disney World vacation detail by detail. Let's go. First up, let's talk the Disney PhotoPass service. So the Disney PhotoPass service is that there are professional photographers that are located all throughout the parks. Everybody can get into the shot and get some magnificent, magical memories. So the Disney PhotoPass service kind of rolls into the Memory Maker, and the Memory Maker is going to be an extra cost that is added to your Walt Disney World Resort vacation if you choose to purchase it. Now we will go into the Memory Maker and everything that it entails for that, but first let's break down the Disney PhotoPass. So number one, let's go over how you collect all of your photos. So depending on which mode of ticket that you decide to choose, whether it's going to be a Keys to the World card, whether it's going to be a Magic Band, or if it is going to be by Magic Mobile and using your smartphone. Both the Keys to the World card and the Magic Mobile service will have a QR code that you are able to give the PhotoPass photographer, and that PhotoPass photographer is going to scan that QR code and it is going to link the pictures that they take of you and your family to your My Disney Experience account. Now let's back up just a little bit. You do need to have the My Disney Experience app downloaded with your account set up, ready to go before you take these pictures. A new thing that has been rolling out throughout the parks is going to be a new service where you are going to be able to get those on-ride photos that before you were only able to get if you had a Magic Band. But now they are beginning to roll out in certain rides across the parks. You will see a certain icon in front of the ride itself before you enter, and it is going to have a QR code that you can scan with your smartphone. What you're going to make sure that you need to do is you are going to need to make sure that your Bluetooth is set up before you get on the ride. Make sure that your My Disney Experience app is open and that you are signed in. From there, as you ride the ride, it will attach your ride photo to your My Disney Experience account. So that is happening throughout the parks and only on certain attractions at the moment. Again, the Magic Band will do this automatically for you, and there are 13 Walt Disney World attractions throughout the parks that do have this service with the Magic Band. If you do decide to either upgrade your reservation with a Magic Band, or if you decide to purchase a Magic Band separately, if you're staying off-site, either way, you can do that. The PhotoPass photographer will scan your Magic Band and they will scan the Mickey icon, which is right here, which holds an RFID chip in it. Now, if you need information about a Magic Band, I will link this video for you and you can go check that out. So that's how you collect all of your different photos from the PhotoPass photographers throughout your entire trip in every single park. Now, there are two magical extras that come with a PhotoPass photographer, and number one is going to be a magic shot. So a magic shot is where you're going to have a digitally enhanced photo, say a Disney character might be in there, you might be holding Mickey balloons or things like that. And different PhotoPass photographers will have different magic shots depending on which park you're in. Now, not every PhotoPass photographer has a magic shot, but for the most part, if a PhotoPass photographer does have a magic shot, they will tell you to either look at something that's not there or hold something that's not there. And then later you're able to see what it is that's in the picture. And sometimes you can kind of tell who the character is or what the scenario is by how you are posed. The second magical thing that you will find with the PhotoPass photographers is called a super zoom. This is going to be a one-of-a-kind, unique picture. In Magic Kingdom, it's going to be located in the hub. In Animal Kingdom, it's going to be in the amphitheater. And then in Hollywood Studios, it's going to be in Galaxy's Edge. So you're going to be looking for a sign that says super zoom, or you can ask any cast member and they will be able to direct you to this location to have that picture done. Now let's talk how you see your photos. So whenever you download the My Disney Experience app, you're going to open it up, and on that first page, you're going to scroll down and you're going to see Disney PhotoPass. In the right hand bottom corner, you're going to see My Photos. You're going to tap that, it's going to go to the next page, and you're going to see all of your photos that have been collected throughout your entire trip. If you bought the Memory Maker, you will also see stock photos that Disney allows you to have and to be able to download. But we'll go over the Memory Maker here in just a second. As you are taking pictures throughout all of the parks and in front of all of the icons, I do have one big tip for you. Make sure that you are checking that you received the picture that you really wanted in front of that icon with everybody in it. There have been times where the scanner of the PhotoPass photographer will glitch and you may end up with another family's photo because it did not register whenever it scanned your either QR code or Magic Band. So just make sure that if there is a specific picture you want, make sure that you have it before you leave the parks. Now that you know about the Disney PhotoPass service throughout the parks and how you get your pictures and how you can see your pictures, let's talk about the Memory Maker and how that gets integrated into getting those pictures. The Memory Maker is going to be something that you are able to add on to your existing Walt Disney World reservation, or if you're staying offsite, you are able to purchase this through your Disney account. So what this is it's going to be one cost for unlimited downloads and social media shares for all of your pictures, all those magical extra shots that you took with the PhotoPass photographers throughout your trip. Now, things to note, there are one-day packages for those guests that only visit whichever park you're visiting for one day. Say if you're just going and you visit Magic Kingdom for one day, that package price is going to be $69 plus tax. If you pre-buy the Memory Maker and you are doing it for an entire length of a trip, it is going to be $169 plus tax. If you wait until you get to Disney and you buy there on site, it is going to be $199 plus tax. You will have access to all of your photos, all of those magic shots for 45 days from when that specific picture was taken. Just a few things to note about the Memory Maker. So number one, if you're in the military and you are using military discounts for your trip, you do get a discount on the Memory Maker, but you have to buy the Memory Maker there at one of the ticket booths at one of the parks, and you must show your military ID to get the discount. Number two, if you are going with a big party, only one person needs to purchase a Memory Maker, or you can all pitch in and it can just be linked to one account. If you have different parties that are going to different areas and in the parks, you can all link together in the family and friends list. Everything will be linked to the one head account and you can see all the pictures that have been taken, no matter who is where in whatever park for the entire trip. And lastly, whenever you get home from your trip and you have that 45-day period, you are able to go to the Disney PhotoPass website. You're able to get everything downloaded on a USB. You're able to get everything loaded down onto a CD for an extra cost. You can also make photo books. So like those magic shots, whenever you have those with kids and their favorite characters in them, that makes for a great keepsake. You can do mugs, calendars, mouse pads, all of that extra kind of stuff can also be done with all of the pictures that you took throughout your entire trip and done on the Disney PhotoPass website. Lastly, let's talk capture your moment photo shoots. So this is going to be something that can be integrated into your Memory Maker, and I'll explain that here in just a second. So a capture your moment photo shoot right now is only at Magic Kingdom, Epcot recently, and then also in Animal Kingdom. What this is a private photo session for 20 minutes. The cost of this is going to be $50, and you are able to book two back-to-back, so that's going to give you a 40-minute photo session, and you are able to choose from two different locations if you do a back-to-back two-session photo shoot. With this photo shoot, you can have up to 8 guests in, and you can pretty much celebrate anything that your heart's desire, but they do have props and have experience of taking the photos with things like honeymoons, engagements, birthdays, of course, your first trip, a baby announcement, a wedding announcement, adoption announcement, basically anything that you can possibly celebrate at Walt Disney World, they can do a photo shoot for. A few important details that you need to know about the Capture Your Moment photo shoot. So number one, the photos that they take are not included in this $50 fee. So if you do not have the Memory Maker, then you will have to purchase these photos for an extra cost. If you do have the Memory Maker, however, they will be added to your account and you can have all of those unlimited downloads and access to them for that 45-day mark all the way up until they expire. So that is, if you plan to do a Capture Your Moment photo shoot, take that into account if you're trying to decide if you want the Memory Maker or not. Reservations are highly, highly recommended for this. So if you are using a Disney travel planner, make sure that you let them know so that they can get that scheduled for you. Or you can call this number right here and be able to do that. And you can also do this online. You will also need a park pass reservation and a park ticket to be able to do this. You cannot just schedule and then be able to go into the park. So make sure that you understand that you need to have everything done in one day when you're at that park. The photo shoot can only be taken during park hours. So there's no before park opening and then there's no after park closing. So everything must be done in the hours of the park for that day that you schedule your appointment. If you have any questions about anything, the Disney PhotoPass, the Memory Maker, or the Capture Your Moment photo shoots, please leave a comment down below. If you found this video helpful at all, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing as I break down Disney World Resort planning for you step by step and detail by detail, because details matter when it comes to planning a most magical vacation. And everybody on that note, have a magical day.